we talked a little bit about the most common mistakes entrepreneurs make in protecting their IP, just all the way through this program, but what other common mistakes should we be mentioning? I'll do one on the trademark side, because I think it's perhaps a little counterintuitive. So for a lot of companies, the protection of a trademark and the marketing is an intertwined operation for a lot of companies. And the marketing people, and we love them because they're very good at their jobs, but they want to be able to have whatever the trademark is going to be, basically describe what it is that you're offering. For trademark law, that's actually not where you want to be. So the U.S. Patent and Trademark Office has kind of two sets of marks that we look at, and one of them is inherently non-registerable, and the other one is inherently registerable. And basically, to put yourself in the inherently registerable mark land, your mark has to be suggestive or arbitrary and fanciful. And that means usually that it's not necessarily describing what it is that you're doing. I usually use Mexican food as the example of like what's not registerable and what is registerable. So I'll do that now. But like, you know, the burrito place is inherently non-registerable because it's a place and you're getting burritos there. And while it's exactly telling you what you are offering, that's not what a trademark is supposed to do, right? The trademark is supposed to be a unique source identifier so that people, when they see that, they know exactly who it is at the time. And so, you know, Qdoba is probably that arbitrary or fanciful. When Qdoba first started, they had to do a lot of marketing in order to tell people that, you know, what fast Mexican food was going to look like and what it was going to taste like. And they built their brand very slowly, but now, right, Qdoba is synonymous with that fast Mexican food. But that's an arbitrary or fanciful mark because it doesn't mean anything in any language. It's just made up. So I really think that, you know, that's a common mistake that people make when they're talking about their brands is in order to be inherently registrable, you've got to be in that arbitrary or fanciful. And that means a trade-off with the marketing department because the marketing people are going to have to work a little bit harder in describing to your customers what you do and who you are. But it pays off immensely in the long run in being able to make sure that you have a brand that's protectable and defensible. Pretty much, at least, you know, if your entrepreneurial dream is worldwide domination for your company, make sure you spend the time to get into arbitrary or fanciful land on the trademark side.